So welcome back. This is the second installment of the closet to mini mudroom conversion. So far it's taken about a weekend to get to this point. Quick recap, we completed the demo, pulled the doors off, installed the wainscoting, painted it, painted the walls, the ceiling, and at this point we're going to go ahead and build the bench and put on the face frame. So we'll go ahead and get started. Okay, so the first step for building the base for the cubbies, and of course the cubbies will support the bench on top, is to build some sort of a base. I've chosen to do that out of just standard stud lumber. You can get it at your local home store. I'm using a 2x6. The 5.5 inches is gonna give me a nice height to then build my base on, build the cubbies, and then the bench on top, and provide me plenty of room to put a nice baseboard across the bottom that'll match with the rest of the house. So nothing too complicated here. I cut this piece out. It's roughly 4 feet across. It's gonna go down here, across the back. I'll secure that with some liquid nails and some screws. And then there's gonna be a piece across the front, and then in between there's gonna be 4 stringers that connect the front to the back. Now those stringers are going to align with the supports for the bench, which will be the dividers for the cubbies. And that's gonna provide plenty of strength to support that bench. So,
as you see me do before, I'm putting a nice bead of liquid nails on to help secure that board. We'll rotate it up against the wall and then secure it with some 3-inch long deck screws right into the studs. Make sure these boards don't go anywhere.
So I got the back board attached, and again, that's with liquid nails. Actually, I use Loctite and screws into the 4 studs, just to provide that security, of course. I've dry fit the stringers and the front piece just to make sure everything is true and square towards the front and back boards at 49.5. And then the stringers are at 14. That's gonna end up giving me a bench depth of about 17.25 to 17.5, depending on the lip that's on the bench. It's all, of course, personal preference and how much room you've got from back to front and from right to left in the space that you're building.
So let's go ahead and permanently attach those stringers and front base support. Again, Loctite and screws. And these 3-inch long screws into the studs really make for a solid fixture. Here's just a quick view of the build, and more Loctite, and then screws across the front to secure the front base support. Okay, now that we have the stringers attached on the front side, we want to ensure that they're square. So we're gonna measure the distance from the wall across the front, make that the same distance in the back, and secure it with a screw.
At this point, the base is done. Didn't take very long to put together, pretty simple. Certainly not a lot of math or anything hard to do construction-wise. It took about 20 minutes to do. The next step is to apply the back. The back is made out of a 1/2 inch piece of plywood. Now I kind of splurged a little bit and got the cabinet grade plywood. I put 3 coats on and sanded in between. If you don't have a table saw, that's okay. I had these cuts made at my home store. They charge 50 cents a cut, and that's a bargain in my book. And they just come home and they're ready to paint and then install. So we'll go ahead and put the back on. Then the base for the cubbies will be here. We don't have to go crazy with the nails here because it's going to be held in by everything else. And this is not really a support structure at all. Just provides a nice back for our cabinet. We're going to go ahead and pop a couple of nails in here, right about where the studs are. I'm just going to put just a little bit more adhesive down here before I nail, and also before I put the base in place, I want to just put a couple of real small tick marks here. I'm not really worried about them being visible after the fact, but I want to make sure that my supports go right above these areas here to support the bench.
We'll add a couple of small beads of Loctite just to help the base board stay in place. We'll lower the board in place and we'll get ready to secure it with some nails.
We need to be real careful that the base, this board right here, is not set behind this face frame. It's okay if it's a little bit forward because we want the solid wood that we put on for our cabinetry facing, we want that to be flush or a little bit proud of this board right here, because what we don't want is to build it out and have a large gap right here. So I already went ahead and put some tick marks here to where it needs to be. We're lined up, and again, a couple of nails. Now, the next thing we're gonna do is we're going to build the partitions. This is Kona. We're gonna build the partitions that define the cubbies and support the bench on top. That's gonna be done with a buildup of 2x4s, 2x2s, with half inch plywood on each side. Okay, let me explain to you what I'm doing here. These are the partitions that will divide up our cabinets below, or the cubbies, okay? These are also going to be the supports for the bench above. So to make these as strong as possible, I cut out some 2x2s, okay? I'm gonna use 2x4s, okay, on the sides, and then there will be a 2x2 on the top, okay? And so what we're gonna have, all of the force of the bench is going down through the bench, these 2x2s, through the 2x4s and then to the base. These 2x2s are going to be right here, which lines up with the 2x6 underneath the base. That way all of the weight of somebody on the bench is going through these structural members here, through the 2x6, down to the floor. It's gonna be about as strong as you'd need it to be. And then there's gonna be another partition piece on top of this, okay? And then it'll be secured to the bench. Now the way I'm gonna do this is, I'm going to put these pieces together without this piece on it, set them here, and then screw them down, and then put the facing pieces on. And then we'll be ready for our bench here. So I've completed putting together the frames. I needed four total, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I thought it'd be good at this point to stop and show you what I've done. So one frame goes up against the wall, and then the plywood facing simply goes on it. Again, just like with the base, we wanted to leave this just a little bit short because I want a nice tight fit with my solid wood facing here on the front when we install our rails and stiles. Okay, so you can see here, I have one of the frames with the plywood facing on it. Over here, you can see how it goes onto the board. I still need to screw it here at the base. I've already put some liquid nails down here, and then I'll put another plywood facing on here. So here's one of the plywood facings. It'll go on just like that. Okay, and then this frame will go here, and this one will go here against the wall. Okay, now at this point, it's real important to stress getting your frames and your facings very straight and square on your base. So you want it plumb this way, back and forth, and then you want it square on the base. Okay, so from this point, I'm going to install the last two, put all the facings on, and then we'll be ready for our bench. Okay, so we have our partitions installed with the facing on each side. The next step will be to put on the seat, which will be made out of this 3/4 inch piece of plywood. I think the best way to go though will be to install the front piece, which will go level with that piece of plywood for the bench. And I splurged a little bit again, and I bought this what's called a 4/4 piece of stock. It's just regular pine. 4/4 is an inch thick. Just give a little heavier look to the front of the bench. Now, to make that look a little nicer, I'm gonna round over this edge. And this is about the one specialized tool, if you will, that I'll be using, and that's, you know, a router. But you know, if you're gonna be doing a lot of home improvement projects, having a good router around is probably a good idea. Okay, so I'm just using a basic fixed base router with a 1/4 inch roundover bit. Makes for pretty quick work. And really dresses up that edge. And then, as always, you want to sand or remove any of the machining marks. Okay, so we've got our piece rounded over, and I put the 3/4 inch plywood down for the bench. What I think is the best way to do this would be to put this piece in place. And I'll do that with liquid nails and my nail gun. And then once this is in place and secure, then I'm going to use a pry bar and just push the plywood against the face piece to get a real nice tight fit. Adding a dab of Loctite here. So I've got my liquid nails here and the face piece on. What I'm going to do is pull the bench tight against it temporarily, just to get the right height on my face piece. And then we'll nail it. Just applied a bead of glue across the front edge of the bench. I'm gonna set that in place. Just easily slide it where I think it needs to be. And I'll check it to make sure I've got an equal amount of space on either side. Now all I'm gonna do is take my pry bar, put it up along the back, right about where I'm gonna nail. I'm not gonna put a whole lot of pressure on it, because I don't want to pop my face frame off. I just want to get it nice and snug. Nice tight fit. I'll just pop a nail in here to hold it for now. And I'll do that on each spot. Okay, now I want to stress that using that pry bar, you don't want to use too much pressure. You just want to apply enough pressure with a couple of fingers to ease a little bit of glue out of that that front seam. And then you want to take some time with a wet paper towel to wipe down that glue, get that glue off there. Next, we're going to apply some liquid nails to the front fascia. And then rotate it into place. Get it lined up. Now this is where leaving that board that's on the top of the base is key, leaving that out a little bit. Lining up the front fascia with that board, get it nice and clean, and then nailing it into place. Okay, so we've got our face drape on, the bench is on, and I put the lower trim piece on. Hey, now it's time to put in place the 4 fascia pieces that'll cover up those 4 dividers that support the bench. These pieces were cut out individually. They're all specific to the position they're going into. Each piece was just slightly different in length than the others. From left to right, I've got a difference in height of about 1/16 of an inch. But that is important. You want it to be nice and tight of a fit. So we're going to set those in place with a little bit of glue on the top pieces. Anywhere where wood meets wood, you want glue. We'll set them in place, liquid nails behind, of course, and then nail them together. And it goes together pretty nicely, as you can see. Okay, so we've got all the facing on, and now it's just a matter of filling all the holes. And what I like to use, I got this tip from a Finnish carpenter. I used to use just caulking, but the spackling works really well. You can put it in, let it dry, sand it, and if you're not happy with the results, you can reapply and then sand again. I like using the stuff that is goes on pink and dries white. It's important to note here, use a stiff putty knife and really work that spackling into the hole. Overfill just a little bit before you start sanding. Okay, so our bench is done. Next video is going to be building out the nice craftsman style surrounds and cornice. And again, since this is so close to the front door, I'm gonna go ahead and pull the existing moldings off the front door and install a matching cornice. In fact, it'll all tie together in the finished project. So that'll be video number 3. So look forward to seeing you there.
Whew. Time for a well-earned brew.
All right, our bench is done. It's been a great weekend's worth of work. We got a lot done, and now it's time to relax and enjoy a nice craft beer. This weekend, we're going to sample the Namaste from the Dogfish Head Brewery. This has been a favorite of mine going long back. That is the Dogfish Head Brewery. I haven't had Namaste yet. Dogfish Head has been a favorite of mine for many years. We're regular travelers over to the Delaware Eastern Shore, Rehoboth Beach, which is where Dogfish Head, I believe, got its start, and I think that's their flagship pub slash restaurant. It's a great spot to go to if you ever get a chance, Dogfish Head Ale House. The story behind Namaste is an interesting one. I guess it kind of has its roots in a sad story that ultimately builds out to be a good news story. The brewers at Dogfish Head, I guess, have some friends over in Belgium that run a brewery. It's the Three Fontienen Brewery in Belgium. I hope I got that pronunciation right. Well, as the story goes, in 2008 or 9, they had a significant loss in a batch of their brew, approximately 100,000 bottles. So the folks at Dogfish Head, the brewers, got together and came up with a recipe for Namaste. And to help their friends over in Belgium recover from this rather significant loss, they sent a significant amount of the profits from the sale of Namaste over to them to help them get back on their feet. So pretty cool story. Good on Dogfish Head for helping out the brewers of the world, so to speak. Okay, well now on to the brew itself. Namaste has a fairly interesting recipe. It's made with organic orange slices, not just the rind, but the orange pulp itself, including the rind, lemongrass, coriander, and peppercorns. So it should be for a pretty interesting flavor. Now, the brewers describe Namaste as a light and very refreshing beer. It's only about 4.8% ABV, which is on the lower scale. Kind of on the lower scale of Dogfish Head brews, their brews tend to be a little bit higher in the alcohol content. All their beers, as far as I'm concerned, are extremely, extremely tasty. So let's go ahead and give her a try. Namaste from Dogfish Head. I probably poured that a little bit fast and a little bit more head than I would prefer. But it does have that traditional wit beer appearance where it is somewhat cloudy. So the head has come down a bit. Just remember, don't pour it too fast. And I think it's about time to give this a try. Good beer. That's what I'd expect from Dogfish Head. It is absolutely refreshing.
Really a good beer to enjoy after a hard weekend's worth of work doing whatever home improvement project you might do. And it does have some very interesting flavors to it. And as with most wit beers, you can definitely taste the citrus. In fact, I think with Namaste, it's probably more than most. Not overpowering. If you like a wit beer and you like those citrus flavors, then you would really enjoy Namaste. It's a great mix of different flavors. To be honest, I'm not really sure what coriander tastes like. But there is something different. Something different in Namaste that I'm picking up, and maybe it is just that coriander. And then there is at the end, there's a certain spiciness, which I guess is those peppercorns that are popping out. Overall, a really, really good beer. As far as what I would drink this with, I would think any kind of chicken or turkey, mostly with a lighter sauce, nothing too heavy. And maybe a white sauce pizza, a little goat cheese would be good. Sun-dried tomatoes, it'd be good. I had a great goat cheese sun-dried tomato pizza in Aspen, Colorado about 100 years ago. And I would think any of your lighter pasta dishes. Nothing too heavy. A light olive oil sauce, or maybe even a lighter cream sauce, would certainly go well with it. So overall, you know, I'm continuing my track of enjoying every beer I've ever tasted. I'm sure there's going to be one out there that I'm not too terribly fond of, but Namaste is not one of them. Namaste is a very good beer. I know it's available through craftbeerkings.com if you want to grab some, and certainly if you're anywhere here in the U.S., you can find it in any of your specialty stores. Depending on where you are, you may not be able to find it at your local grocery store, but certainly a BevMo or a Total Wine, something along those lines, you could find it at. So I don't want to throw around the hammers too much, but I think I got to go 5 hammers out of 5 on the Namaste. It is super good. In fact, I think after I turn off the video, I'm going to have another one. So that brings us to the end of this weekend's DIY work. We've got our bench done. Just enjoyed a fantastic beer, Namaste, from Dogfish Head. And I hope you all enjoyed it. Hope you all learned something and maybe got a good tip on a fantastic beer to enjoy with friends next weekend. So with that, I'm going to race to the fridge and grab another Namaste. And I'll see you back here to work on our door surrounds and real nice craftsman style cornice. So thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.